The nurse checked the patient's chart again, blinking hard to clear her vision. 47 hours into her shift rotation during a hospital crisis, she reached for what she thought was insulin. Her hand trembled slightly as she drew the clear liquid into the syringe, but her exhausted brain had misread the label. What she held wasn't insulin, it was a paralytic drug 10 times more potent. Only the sharp voice of a colleague snapped her back to reality before the injection. Later, reviewing security footage, she would have no memory of the previous 15 minutes. She had been awake, walking, talking, making medical decisions, but her brain had been asleep. This is sleep deprivation, and it happens every day in hospitals, cockpits, and behind the wheels of cars on every highway in the world. Sleep is one of the most basic needs of the human body. Miss a meal, and you'll feel hunger. Miss a night of sleep, and your entire system begins to unravel. For most people, tiredness means yawning at work or needing an extra coffee. But push the limits, and sleep loss stops being an inconvenience. It becomes a breakdown of mind and body that can end in death. This is what happens at every stage of sleep deprivation, from the moment you first stay up too late to the point where your brain and body can no longer keep you alive. At the 12-hour mark, nothing seems unusual. You woke up early, stayed up late, and now you're tired. This is the everyday state for most people. Slightly less sharp, a bit more irritable, but still fully functional. Your reaction time is only subtly slower, perhaps an extra tenth of a second to hit the brakes. Focus requires more effort, like trying to read through slightly fogged glasses. Most of us live here without noticing, convinced coffee can replace sleep. But even at this mild stage, changes are cascading through your body. Adenosine, the chemical that makes you feel sleepy, has been building in your brain for hours longer than it should. Your body temperature drops slightly, metabolism begins to slow, and growth hormone production remains suppressed. These are the first cracks in a system that depends on precise biological timing. After 18 hours awake, the cracks begin to show. Concentration falters, memory stumbles, and decisions are sloppier. Your prefrontal cortex, the brain's executive center, starts to go offline. Researchers measure impairment equal to having a blood alcohol level of 0.05%, not enough to knock you down, but enough to make driving dangerous. You might find yourself reading the same paragraph three times, forgetting why you walked into a room, or snapping at colleagues over trivial matters. Truckers on long hauls and hospital residents on overnight shifts often function at this stage, and accidents are common because of it. The body is still pushing forward, fueled by stress hormones like cortisol and adrenaline, but it's already running on fumes. Your immune system begins to weaken as natural killer cells drop in number. Inflammation markers rise in your blood as if your body is fighting an infection that doesn't exist. This is the beginning of your body's rebellion against consciousness. At the 24-hour mark, a full day without rest, the decline is obvious. People in sleep labs at this stage show cognitive performance cut in half. Speech becomes slower, like a record played at the wrong speed. Simple calculations that would normally take seconds now require concentrated effort. Memory gaps appear. You set down your keys and genuinely cannot remember where. Hand-eye coordination resembles someone legally drunk. The brain begins producing microsleeps, uncontrollable lapses where it shuts down for anywhere from a fraction of a second to 30 seconds, even with eyes open. During these microsleeps, your brain shows the electrical patterns of sleep while you remain upright and apparently conscious. Behind the wheel of a car, those seconds are enough to kill. The neurotransmitter systems keeping you alert are now severely depleted. Dopamine plummets, serotonin becomes erratic, and your brain's waste-clearing system backs up for hours, leaving toxic proteins to accumulate between neurons. 36 hours without sleep raises stress hormones to emergency levels. Cortisol floods your system at concentrations normally seen only in severe trauma. Blood pressure spikes, blood sugar swings wildly out of control, and the immune system already begins to weaken. Emotional regulation collapses. People snap in anger, burst into tears, or feel crushing anxiety for no reason. A study of medical interns showed diagnostic accuracy dropping by 25% at this stage, with mistakes happening in basic procedures they had performed hundreds of times before. Your body temperature regulation begins to fail. You might feel intensely cold one moment and burning hot the next, as your hypothalamus loses its ability to process sensory information correctly. You are awake, but not truly functional. After two full days, or 48 hours, the body enters crisis. The immune system produces fewer white blood cells. Inflammation spreads, metabolism slows, reflexes are sluggish, speech slurs, and vision blurs. Hallucinations often begin, lights flashing at the corner of vision, phantom voices, objects seeming to move on their own. In laboratories, participants report the sensation of dreaming while awake. The brain is fighting to enter REM sleep, but being blocked from doing so, fragments of dream imagery leak into waking reality. At 72 hours, 3 days without sleep, the body and brain are in open revolt. Balance and coordination break down so badly that walking in a straight line becomes difficult. Memory vanishes in minutes. Thoughts lose order, and speech can become nonsensical. Hallucinations are no longer flickers, but sustained scenes, sometimes indistinguishable from reality. A participant in a 1960s experiment tried to play basketball at this point and described the ball turning into a small dog in his hands. Emotional swings are extreme. Rage one moment, euphoria the next, paranoia soon after. Judgment is so impaired that people may insist they are fine while barely able to hold a conversation. After 4 days, the nervous system begins collapsing. Hormones regulating appetite, temperature, and growth plunge out of balance. Pain sensitivity doubles, muscles ache, skin tingles, and body temperature drifts unpredictably. The mind resembles psychosis. Paranoia, delusions, and vivid hallucinations dominate consciousness. In some reports, people believe they are being followed or attacked, reacting with fear to threats that don't exist. At this stage, even if you try to force yourself awake, the brain fights back with prolonged microsleeps. You may black out standing up, only to wake in another room with no memory of how you got there. By the fifth day, reality breaks apart. The immune system is nearly non-functional, making minor infections potentially lethal. In one famous experiment, Randy Gardner, a 17-year-old student, stayed awake for 11 days in 1964. By day 5, he suffered severe mood swings, difficulty speaking, and hallucinations of road signs morphing into people. Observers noted he could no longer recite simple sequences of numbers. The heart strains harder, with irregular rhythms and rising blood pressure. Hallucinations are immersive, entire conversations with people who do not exist. Past 120 hours, research becomes sparse because most people cannot continue without collapsing. Those forced to remain awake, such as in extreme military experiments or torture, show catastrophic breakdowns. The brain loses grip on time, with subjects unable to tell if minutes or hours have passed. Speech is incoherent, movements jerky. Infections take hold easily. In some cases, psychosis becomes indistinguishable from schizophrenia. Reality itself is gone. After a week without sleep, the human body enters systemic collapse. In rats deprived completely of rest, death occurs within 2 to 3 weeks, typically from immune failure and infections their bodies can no longer fight. In humans, forced deprivation beyond 7 to 10 days causes seizures, heart arrhythmias, and eventual organ failure. Death from sleep loss alone is rare, only because the body usually forces unconsciousness first, but when paired with stress or illness, survival is unlikely. At 10 days and beyond, only scattered accounts exist. Victims subjected to prolonged deprivation in prisons often broke mentally before physical death, unable to distinguish dreams from reality, speaking nonsense, or sitting catatonic. Doctors believe neurons begin dying from stress and overactivity, leaving permanent damage. Hallucinations are no longer vivid stories, but chaotic fragments. Blood pressure, heart rate, and body temperature swing violently. Organ failure follows. The end is not a peaceful sleep, but collapse under total exhaustion. Most people will never approach those extremes, but the modern world keeps millions trapped in lower levels of deprivation every day. A single night cut short by scrolling on a phone. A week of only 5 hours a night while working 2 jobs. Chronic short sleep does not produce hallucinations, but it corrodes health quietly and relentlessly. The effects accumulate like radiation exposure. Sleeping 6 hours instead of 8 might seem like a minor compromise, but over months and years, it creates a sleep debt that can never be fully repaid. Risk of obesity climbs as hunger hormones become dysregulated. Ghrelin increases while leptin decreases, leaving you constantly craving food. Heart disease and stroke risk doubles. Type 2 diabetes becomes significantly more likely as insulin resistance develops, creating a pre-diabetic state in otherwise healthy individuals. Mental health disorders surge in the chronically sleep-deprived. Depression and anxiety rates are 2 to 3 times higher in those getting less than 6 hours nightly. Reaction times slow enough to cause car accidents. One study found drowsy driving caused more crashes than alcohol. Another showed that sleeping less than 6 hours a night doubles the risk of dying in middle age. The immune system weakens progressively, making you more susceptible to everything from common colds to cancer. Memory consolidation fails night after night, leaving you unable to form lasting memories effectively. Perhaps most insidiously, chronic sleep loss impairs your ability to recognize how impaired you are. After a few weeks of insufficient sleep, people feel they've adapted, but testing shows their performance remains severely compromised. They have entered what researchers call walking zombie syndrome, functional enough to go through daily motions, but operating at a fraction of their capacity. The truth is that sleep deprivation is not just about the extremes of 11-day experiments or horror stories of torture. It is a spectrum most of us live on. Missing one night makes you clumsy and irritable. Missing several makes you confused and paranoid. Push too far, and your body and brain begin to disintegrate. Sleep begins as restoration. It heals memory, strengthens the immune system, balances hormones, and keeps the brain sane. But deny it, and the same systems that protect you collapse one after another. From a late night to a hallucinated nightmare, from irritability to organ failure, every step shows what humans can endure and where they finally break. You don't just lose sleep, you lose yourself.